I'm still basking in the
testing one, two, there we go. Sorry, that was not your guys' fault, that was me. I'm still basking in the glow of SDSU's victory over NDSU.
Oh, look at that, yes. So as a result of that, I'm still trying to figure out what I'm doing this morning, though. Just kidding. Good morning. Good morning and welcome as we gather together on another really incredibly nice day. It was a little windy yesterday, a little cold, but hey, fall, okay, one word. It's fall and that's what we're all about. Several announcements to bring to your attention. I've been running up and down the stairs. I'm not in very good shape at all, so you'll have to excuse me, but our radio broadcast for this week's worship service is in memory of Burl Ippi Olson from Lorraine Olson and Family, and we thank them for their sponsorship of our radio broadcasts. We've got several things going on today. Immediately following worship, please join us downstairs for another segment of Coffee with the Council. And following that, an announcement that the Transitional Task Force meets this evening at 6:30 p.m. For all of you who are committee members and things like that, our annual meeting reports for the semi-annual meeting booklet are due on Friday, October 21st. Please email the Grace Lutheran, and that way you won't get a phone call from me, and especially you won't get a phone call from Pylee. I've had those phone calls before from her, just very nicely saying, you know, Pastor, we truly do need to have that report. Okay. Several other things happening. You know, you can tell it's almost Christmas because the Grace Youth are beginning to sell Christmas wreaths already. And so we know that time is near. We have, as I said, a plethora of things in our announcement. So please make sure you bring this home with you and take a look at everything. On our prayer requests for this week, we have James Harner, we have Brett Swenson, we have Steve Klosterbauer, we have Betty Hammond, and we pray for our four-year-olds who are receiving their four-year-old milestone today. We have some other things that are happening as well, but as I'm feeling my body, I think what the problem is, and I can hear my stomach grumbling, because I had one slice of toast at 5:30 this morning, and that's not enough, and so I may need something else. Ooh. Look at that. You just say a word to the confirmation students and they come out. Wow. Oh, sweet. A chair would have been nice, though. Thank you. Look, they know everything. They know everything. Thank you, sir. Oh, my gosh. Satisfied? Oh my gosh. They actually have been warmed up. I tell you what, you guys just talk amongst yourself for a while. Actually, if anybody wants some of this, the first Sunday in November, starting at 4:30 and going to 6:30, we are having our very first congregational family fall dinner. On the menu will be mashed potatoes and gravy, corn, meatballs, French bread, coffee, wine, no,
No, not wine, but punch, and pumpkin pie, and whipped cream for dessert. It is going to be a full meal. We invite everyone in the congregation to attend. If you have next door neighbors that you want to invite, for goodness sake, invite them as well. And this might be the prelude to not only having this every fall, but something that might even grow bigger, as inviting the entire community and having different menus each time. But first Sunday in November, 4:30 to 6:30, be here and you can enjoy this as well. Thank you. And thank the confirmands too for helping me out. Now they can come and get it all and bring it back. Thank you. Thank you, guys. We need to get started here. We continue with our four-year-olds. Would four-year-olds and their parents come forward, please?
All right, there's always a plan B. So, good morning to all of our four-year-olds, or our four-year-old class. I know some of us turn five throughout the school year, but welcome. This morning, this class is receiving a bedtime devotional. It's called PJ Time, 100 Devotions to Light Up the Night. So all of our friends here today, before you close your eyes at night and say goodnight to another day, I want you to remember you are loved and treasured. Even if you have a bad day or feel sad or mad, God loves you and gives you the strength and courage to shine your light. And shining your light doesn't mean using an actual flashlight. Shining your light means helping others, being kind and generous, being a friend, and as you read your book with your grown-ups, you will get to talk about ways you can keep shining your light every day and every night. So they are a pretty neat book, and I hope you really enjoy going through. There's a little devotional and prayer and sometimes a little activity that you can do or even just questions to talk about. So let's do a quick prayer. You guys can fold your hands. Dear God, as we pass on your word to these boys and girls, help them shine your light in the world. Let these devotions give them quality time with their families and guide them to discover ways to shine their light for Jesus by showing kindness, love, and generosity to others every day. We pray that these children know your unconditional love, and when they go to sleep each night, they can feel happy and content, knowing they are special in God's eyes. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Thank you, Eric. Will the congregation please rise as we continue our worship with a brief order of confession and forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please take a moment at this time for silent prayer and for self-examination. Most merciful God, We confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare unto you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And being we're all up and standing, let's turn and let's share God's peace with one another this morning. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Also with you.
Please join with me in our prayer of the day. Let us pray. O Lord God, tireless guardian of your people, you are always ready to hear our cries. Teach us to rely day and night on your care. Inspire us to seek your enduring justice for all this suffering world. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated. We continue our worship service with the reading of the lesson.
Our first reading is Genesis chapter 32, verses 22 to 31. That night Jacob got up and took his two wives, his two maids, and his 11 children, and crossed the ford of the Jabbok. He took them and sent them across the stream, and likewise everything that he had had. Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him until daybreak. When the man saw that he did not prevail against Jacob, he struck him on the hip socket, and Jacob's hip was put out of joint as he wrestled with him. Then he said, "Let me go, for the day is breaking." But Jacob said, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." So I said to him, "What is your name?" And he said, "Jacob." Then the man said, "You shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, for you have striven with God and with humans and have prevailed." Then Jacob asked him, "Please tell me your name." But he said, "Why is it that you ask my name?" And there he blessed him. So Jacob called the place Peniel, saying, "I have seen God face to face, and yet my life is preserved." The sun rose upon him as he passed Peniel, limping because of his hip. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For our psalm today, we have a little surprise. I noticed that the psalm reading was actually the Bible memory verse our Sunday school first through fifth graders learned this past month. So I did not tell them about this, but what I'd like us to do now is, if you're a first through fifth grader, we're all going to stand up. First through fifth graders, stand up right where you are. And we're going to do our Bible memory verse. Remember, this is the one where we look up to the mountains and do all of our hands. Okay? Let's do it. Should we repeat it? Because I didn't give a warning. So I'll read it, and you guys say it back nice and loud, okay? So we have, I look up to the mountains.
I look up to the mountains.
Does my help come from there?
Does my help come from there?
My help comes from the Lord.
My help comes from the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
Who made heaven and earth.
Thank you guys for doing that.
And so we're going to read that same psalm, only a little bit longer. Our psalm today is 121. Let us read responsibly. I look up to the mountains. Does my help come from there? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life.
The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore.
Our second reading is 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 14 through chapter 4, verse 5. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and firmly believed, knowing from whom you learned it, and how from childhood you have known the sacred writings that are able to instruct you for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that everyone who belongs to God may be proficient, equipped for every good work. In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who is to judge the living and the dead, and in view of his appearing and his kingdom, I solemnly urge you, proclaim the message. Be persistent whether the time is favorable or unfavorable. Convince, rebuke, and encourage with the utmost patience in teaching. The time is coming when people will not put up with sound doctrine, but have itching ears. They will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit their own desires and will turn away from listening to the truth and wander away to myths. As for you, always be sober, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, carry out your ministry fully. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the reading of the gospel.
Gospel for this Sunday morning comes to us from the Gospel according to St. Luke, the 18th chapter, beginning with the first verse.
Glory to you, Lord.
Then Jesus told them a parable about their need to pray always and not lose heart. He said, "In a certain city there was a judge who neither feared God nor had respect for the people. In that city there was a widow who kept coming to him and saying, Grant me justice against my opponent.' For a while he refused, But later he said to himself, though I have no fear of God and no respect for anyone, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will grant her justice, so that she may not wear me out by continually coming. And the Lord said, listen to what the unjust judge says. And will not God grant justice to his chosen ones who cry to him day and night? Will he delay long in helping them? I tell you, he will quickly grant justice to them. And yet, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated, and I would invite the children forward for a children's message this morning.
He's got the whole world in his hands. 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 He's got everybody here in his hands. He's got everybody here in his hands. He's got everybody here in his hands. He's got the whole world 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 in his hands.
We had to wait till some of them came down from the mountain. Good morning. How is everybody today? Say, before I start saying anything else, I want to tell you guys how much... Hi there, how you doing? You are? I'm not. In December? Well, happy birthday in a couple of months. I've lost this already, you guys know that. So. But I want to say thank you for all those incredible cups that you gave me last week. I tell you what, I had so much fun. It was like Christmas in October when I got home, because I sat at the kitchen table and I opened up every one of them, and I tell you, there's two or three things that are going to happen. I'm going to have to really go on a diet, because there was so much candy, there was so much goodies in there. There were McDonald's gift certificates and Subway gift certificates and, oh my gosh, everything else. But thank you guys. I tell you what, I think my wife said, I haven't seen you smile like this in ages. And it was actually all afternoon. But thank you guys. That was absolutely incredible. And there were some older children that sent me stuff too, and I thank you guys as well. See who I got up here with me? Whenever you guys and gals see that, it probably means that my message today is going to be about one of those characters, okay? We did this before. How many think that my message is going to be about Kinga and Rue back here? No? A couple, though. How about Eeyore? A few more. I like Eeyore, right? How about Winnie the Pooh? Yeah, kind of, sort of. How about Tigger? How about Rat? No? How about Piglet? No? No? Well, you're wrong, because it is going to be about Piglet today. And I'm going to tell you some things about Piglet that Piglet is trying to do. Because, as you know from Winnie the Pooh and the other characters of the 100 Acre Woods, Piglet is scared of his own shadow. I mean, he truly is. He's kind of a scaredy cat. But he's working on that. So I want you guys to listen to the message today, because you're going to hear about some of the things that Piglet is trying to do, all right? But for now, let's do this. Let's fold our hands. And we'll say the prayer. I'll say it first, and you guys repeat it. Dear God, another great day, another great weekend. Thank you for today. Thank you for being our God. Amen. Help yourself, gang.
got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world.
All right, thank you.
In his hands, he's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. 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 He's got the whole world in his hands.
Change of color. I gotta go shopping again. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Gracious God, on again this beautiful weekend that you have blessed us with, allowing our farmers to continue with the harvest, we pray that you are with us this day. We pray that that even in the words of a little character like Piglet, we can gain knowledge about your love for us. Be with us this day and each day. All this we ask, all this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The psalm that that we read is probably one of my favorite psalms. It is a psalm that I have shared with families before the funeral of a loved one, probably at every funeral that I have ever done in 30 plus years. It is a psalm that provides comfort. Comfort out of fear. Because those first few words in that psalm, I lift up my eyes to the hills, from where is my help to come? It's truly a statement of fear, of suddenly having no idea where your help was going to be from. You know, I remember when I was a kid, I don't know if you guys ever had this in Laverne. We had Saturday afternoon free movies for the kids. Did they used to have that here too? I think at one time all towns that had theaters and that. And it was a free show, and of course it was a marketing deal as well. Because it got the whole family into town. You drop off the kids at the movie theater, and then they could go do shopping and whatever else they needed to do for a couple of hours. The kids loved it because the DeMars Theater in Benson was filled every Saturday. And one of the great things was you know how much money my folks gave me? A quarter. That's right, 25 cents. But with that 25 cents, I could buy a pop, I could buy a box of popcorn, and I could get my favorite candy in the world, Milk Duds. And I was set. I had my Milk Duds, I had my pop, I had my popcorn, and I just went in there and just had fun. But it was always seemed that there were people who were in trouble and were waiting for help, right? And of course, a lot of times too, you know, the desperados would be coming in and they would have just taken the stagecoach and they would take it hostage and they would be holed up and who was going to save them? And suddenly, over the top of the hill, here comes the sheriff and the entire posse and everything else. And they were so outnumbered that they just all, you know, went, and just gave up like that. But we were always ready to see who was going to come over the top of the hill and rescue them. As I told the kids, Piglet truly is scared of his own shadow. For Piglet, every time he goes out, every time he's involved with anything, you know, his commander statement is, oh, did it a deer. Oh my, he's always afraid, but he's working on it. In fact, one day, he decided, you know what? I am going to go right up myself with nobody's help. And I'm going to go to that one hill in the 100-acre woods where it's higher than any place else. And by myself, I'm going to go up there and I'm going to watch the sunshine. You see, Piglet, along with all of his friends, used to do that about two or three times a week. They would go up to this hill at night, and they'd sit there, and at dawn, they would just bask in the glory that the Lord hath made as the sun came rising over the top. Well, that was probably not the smartest thing in the world that Piglet could have done, because, as I said, he was scared of his own shadow. But he starts out in the night. What's the one thing that frightens more people than anything else? Darkness. Darkness. Which always shocks me, because I watch all these horror movies, and what's the first thing that they do? They go down in the basement and they don't turn the light on. You know, that makes no sense at all. But they do. Everybody does it. Because people fear the darkness. We do. Piglet was no exception. He starts out on his journey, and he's got all the best intentions. But somewhere around the middle of the night, Piglet gets absolutely, totally lost. He has no idea where he is. He thinks to himself, I might be just walking around in circles and have no idea where I'm going to be. I don't know what's going to happen to me. Are the heffalumps and the woozles going to come out? And are they going to destroy me? He laid down. He couldn't get to sleep. His eyes were wide open. But it was at that moment that he kind of folded his little hands. And he just started saying some prayers. His prayers were, oh, God, wouldn't it be great if my friends would come to my help? Wouldn't it be something? Well, it was very early in the morning. He looked around. It was still dark. He didn't know where he was. He still didn't know what he was going to do. Everything made him afraid. And then all of a sudden, he heard it behind him. And he knew it's got to be a heffalump or a woozle. And they're coming to get me. And it's going to be the end. He folded his hands one last time, and he prayed one last time, just wishing that sometime again he could see his friends. And then all of a sudden he heard it. Woo-hoo-hoo! Hello, buddy boy! It's me, Digger! What are you doing out here? Piglet was just amazed. Digger repeated the question, what are you doing out here? He told him what had happened. And Digger just shook his head and he said, why didn't you wait for us? And suddenly from behind he heard other statements. Eeyore, Rabbit, Winnie the Pooh. The whole crew was coming up. Piglet never felt so happy and so relieved and so joyous as he got up to the top of the hill and sat down with his friends. And they waited until suddenly darkness turned to light. And the glory and the miracle that God performs each and every day of our lives was there. You and I sometimes get into those predicaments. We're afraid. We don't know what's going to happen next. We have no idea who is coming over the top of the hill to save us. We pray to God. We ask God, please, please, I lift up my eyes to the hills From where is my help to come? My help. Your help. Our help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Amen. We continue with our song of the day. Please rise. Please join with me as together we confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please bow your heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, again, we thank you for another glorious fall weekend. Lord, we thank you for your words from the psalm today, that whenever we are in danger, whenever we are in trouble, help us to always know that you are there. Help us to know that when we lift up our eyes, our help comes from you. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord, we thank you for this time of year in our church. We thank you for the joy. We thank you for the Sunday school kids. We thank you for the confirmants. We thank you for all the groups that gather together and make this place such an incredible place to be. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
And now, Heavenly Father, in the silence of our hearts, we offer up prayers and petitions heard only by you. To your hands, O Lord, we commend for all that we pray, trusting in your word. Amen. Please be seated. We accept our offering at this time. Please rise. God, in your great love, you richly provide for our needs. Make these gifts a banquet of blessing, and make us ready to share with all in need, through Jesus Christ, who sets a table for us all. Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Please join with me as we pray together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Just a couple of words. Communion this day will be continuous, meaning that the ushers will direct you to come up the center aisles, and you'll receive the bread, you'll receive the wine, and then someone will have a basket for the empties. And a statement that that I should make a whole lot more. I made it every week when I was a pastor of St. Dismas of South Dakota, the prison congregation, was that you know, every week we would have visitors, and that every week individuals sitting in the seats in front of us would be maybe even new to the faith or just checking out the faith. And one of the things I always said to them that it might be a little tighter in other churches, but please know that if you believe that Jesus Christ is your Lord and your Savior, you are welcome to the table here. I said, if you believe that God sent his Son to save you, you are welcome to the table of grace here at Grace. I want, especially if you're visiting with us, I want you to know that, because all are welcome. The ushers will usher you forward. We will begin at the transit sites. the congregation please rise? In the name of the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen. Please bow your heads in prayer. God of abundant table, you have refreshed our hearts in this meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road that we might serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our sending song is Day by Day. The blessing. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Worship is ended. Go in peace.